From your hyperlocal weather source, this is your Norcast weather update. Brought to you by Storybook Land and EHT. Enter a world of wonder and whimsy and create everlasting memories for your family. Over 15 rides and dozens of themed attractions. For tickets, hours, and more info, visit storybookland.com.
Hey everybody, thanks so much for checking us out on the Norcast Weather Channel. Today is all about location, location, location. It is brighter, it is warmer to the north, cloudier with the chance of some showers the farther south you go. And we definitely have that onshore flow aiding in keeping those clouds pretty much locked in. So we go from the mid and upper 70s for most, with the exception of maybe around Philadelphia, north and west, and we stay around there. Then we'll get into the 60s, very status quo for tonight. Overnight into tomorrow, there will likely be some areas of rain. It's going to be muggy, blah, overall. Then we get better through the day on Wednesday. We'll probably wake up the clouds and lingering showers Wednesday morning, but if you have golf plans, if you have beach plans, I think Wednesday afternoon is going to be fine. And then we are looking at some rounds of tidal flooding, and I think that starts on Tuesday night and could be with us through the end of the week. Not only do we have major Hurricane Franklin out there in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean churning up the surf, but later in the week we're going to have Idalia emerging off the Carolina coastline, also churning up the surf, and we have the full moon. It's not going to be anything major, but there will certainly be some issues, especially in those low-lying areas. 50% chance of rain on Tuesday, 40% on Wednesday, and then we go into your holiday weekend on a nice, bright, and pleasant note. How about that? For the first time ever, I'm going away on vacation, and there's nothing going on here at home. Hopefully, I didn't just jinx that. Down to the south, this is the system bringing us the chance of scattered showers. Frontal system comes to the north. Low pressure just kind of takes the sweet old time coming through tomorrow, keeping things generally unsettled into Wednesday morning. But Wednesday afternoon, we should be looking better. For tonight, chance of scattered showers and thunderstorms, 60-70s, northeast winds at about 5 to 10 miles an hour. Tomorrow, I think we get into the lower 80s for some, but we're going to keep that chance of rain pretty much all day long. Might not rain all day, but the chance will be there. Let's talk about Idalia. I think it is going to make landfall on Wednesday morning as a major hurricane. So Category 3, I think, is pretty much locked in at this point. There is potential that it gets a little bit stronger. These things intensify usually just before landfall. Here's your probabilities of tropical storm force winds in the next few days. 70% chance in Gainesville, same thing in Tampa. And then obviously as you go north and west or south and east, those chances are going to taper off. My big concern with this storm, because of the geography, because of the way that Idalia is moving, the stacking of the tides. So Horseshoe Beach, Cedar Key, down into Bayonet Point, you're probably looking at a storm surge over 5 feet. That is going to be bringing major flooding, even around the Tampa Bay area. That bay could be backing up with 3 to 6 feet of additional water on top of your normal tides. For us here at home, no concerns whatsoever. Let me repeat that. No concerns. Why? Well, we've got this trough. This cooler air is actually going to be our saving grace because that jet stream is just to the south and it is going to whisk Idalia out to sea along with Franklin. If this high was about 500 miles to the east, we would be in trouble right now, but that is not going to be the case. We stay unsettled through early Wednesday morning. We become partly sunny on Thursday. Temperatures stay below normal. And for your holiday weekend, things are looking really nice. Have yourselves a great day, everybody.